Good morning students. In this video, I am going to discuss about the chapter thermodynamics. So thermodynamics is one of the chapter which belongs to physical chemistry and it is most important for objective purpose. Now we'll see about the problems which are very important for the objective case. So first we'll see about the two important concepts from where the questions will be asked for the objective. First one is enthalpy of formation. Next one is enthalpy of combustion. So from these two topics, there is a chance to ask a question for objective. So we will discuss first what is enthalpy of formation and what is enthalpy of combustion. So first we'll see what is enthalpy of formation. So enthalpy of formation is nothing but the enthalpy change occur during the formation of one mole of the compound from its constituent elements in their standard state. Okay, so a compound can be formed. For the formation of such compound, one mole of compound, whatever the enthalpy can be changed from its constituent elements in its standard state, then that is called enthalpy of formation. So here we are discussing this enthalpy of formation particularly for one mole of compound. Particularly for one mole of compound. So we can call it as standard enthalpy of formation. So and how this one mole of compound is formed? So from its constituent elements in their standard states. Okay, each and every element in the nature can exist in particular standard states. By that standard states, we can easily say what is the enthalpy change can be occur for the formation of that one mole of compound. Okay, so that is called as enthalpy of formation. Okay, so now here enthalpy, standard enthalpy of formation for each compound is assumed to be zero. Okay, so standard enthalpy of formation of the compound is assumed to be zero. So in general, we will assume it to be zero. So that is about the definition of enthalpy of formation. Now, we'll see what are the standard states of those elements. Okay, so different elements can be involved in the reaction. So here few important elements I am giving in their standard state which are participates in the reaction. So example, carbon. Each and every organic reaction is composed with the carbon atom. So carbon in the nature can exist in the form of graphite and oxygen. For combustion we can use this oxygen. So oxygen is one of the standard element which can exist in gaseous state, and standard state of hydrogen is gas. And standard state of chlorine is Cl2 gas, fluorine is F2 gas, and nitrogen is N2 gas, bromine is Br2 liquid, iodine is I2 liquid, phosphorus is P4 white in case, sulfur is S8 orthorhombic, sodium is S, that is solid in state, magnesium is solid in state, aluminium is solid in state. So all these are the standard states of different types of elements or constituent elements exist in the nature. In the nature, carbon always exists as graphite, oxygen always exists as gas, hydrogen exists as gas, chlorine, fluorine, nitrogen can also exist as gas, whereas bromine and iodine in nature can exist as liquid in their standard state, whereas phosphorus can exist in white color, sulfur can exist in orthorhombic state, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, other elements which can exist in liquid state. So that is about the standard states of different elements. Now we have seen what are the standard states of different constituent elements participates in a chemical reaction for the formation of one mole of compound. Now we'll see how to represent this enthalpy of formation. So in general, enthalpy is indicated by H. Change in enthalpy is indicated by delta H. So now it is for the formation, we can write it as delta FH. So change in enthalpy of formation. If it is taking place at a standard condition, then put a not on this. That's it. That is the symbol which is used to represent about the standard enthalpy of formation. Or we can also represent it another form, delta HF not. Like this also we can represent. So this is about the symbol which is used to represent about standard enthalpy of formation. Okay, for example, here I am taking enthalpy of formation, calculate enthalpy of formation of ammonia. So ammonia is forming, so write it on right side because this is forming as a product. So consider it as on a right side. So to form this NH3 gas, what are the two elements present in this? The two constituent elements present in the ammonia is nitrogen and hydrogen, right? Nitrogen and hydrogen. These two are the constituent elements present in ammonia. Now take this standard state. Nitrogen standard state is N2 gas. Hydrogen standard state is H2 gas. Okay, take a screenshot of this. So this is very important because in every reaction we will take standard states of different types of elements. N2 gas and H2 gas present in NH3. Okay, now we want to take. So here we want to balance on both sides. So the coefficient of ammonia gas formed here is only 1. Nothing is represented, indicates that only 1 mole of ammonia gas is formed. To form this 1 mole of ammonia, how many nitrogens are required? Only 1 nitrogen. But here we have taken it 2. So consider it as half. Okay, 2 get cancelled, we will get only 1. And hydrogen present here are 3. Okay, so to balance this hydrogens, take here 3/2. Then 2 get cancelled, we will get 3. Okay, so like this we will balance the equation. If you balance the equation, then it is very easy to find out about enthalpy of formation or enthalpy of combustion. Okay, so that is first, if you want to find out what is enthalpy of formation, first write down or make a reaction of that particular product from the constituent elements. So this is how we will find out enthalpy of formation, and these are the standard states of different types of elements. Now we'll see what is enthalpy of combustion. So here we can see enthalpy of combustion definition. So enthalpy change, enthalpy is nothing but change in heat energy. Enthalpy change occurs during the combustion of 1 mole of compound. So to combust 1 mole of compound, whatever the change occur in the enthalpy, that is called enthalpy of combustion. So if you burn a compound, what happens? Its heat energy may increases or decreases. That is called change in enthalpy. That change in enthalpy occur during combustion of 1 mole of a compound at standard condition is called standard enthalpy of combustion. So that is about its definition. Now we'll see how to represent this enthalpy of combustion. So enthalpy of combustion can be represented. First, enthalpy is indicated by H. Change in enthalpy is indicated by delta H. Change in enthalpy for which process? Combustion process. So take here C. So if it is standard condition, take here not. Change in enthalpy for the combustion at standard condition is indicated like this. Delta CH not. Or we can also represent in another form. Delta HC naught. That's it. That is about the representation of change in enthalpy of combustion at standard condition. So that is what I have represented here. Either like this or like this we will represent. That is change in enthalpy of combustion. First of all, we will recall what is meant by combustion. Combustion is nothing but burning of a compound in presence of air or excess amounts of oxygen is called combustion. Combustion is nothing but burning of a compound in presence of air or in presence of excess amount of oxygen is called combustion. So here I am taking one of the example, combustion of H2. That means we want to heat this hydrogen in presence of air or oxygen. Then that is called combustion of hydrogen. So we want to combust this so that take it on left side, on reactant side. For formation, we want to take it on right side. For combustion, we want to take it on left side. I am taking H2. Okay, it is undergoing which reaction? Combustion. That is burning in presence of oxygen. When these two are combust, it can be, hydrogen can be completely converted into H2O liquid. Okay, hydrogen which is on combustion in presence of oxygen, it can be completely converted into H2O liquid. Okay, H2 in nature can exist in gaseous state, O2 in nature can exist in gaseous state. Now balance the reaction on both the side. So totally we have taken here only one mole of H2 gas, because it is only undergoing combustion, we want to balance from that. So totally 1 into 2, 2 hydrogens, even here 2 hydrogens, both the sides hydrogen is balanced. Whereas in standard state, oxygen is present in the form of O2. Okay, but here we have only one oxygen. Now to balance that oxygen, take here 1 by 2, that is half. 2, 2 get cancelled and we will get only one oxygen this side and one oxygen this side, then completely balanced on both the sides. So this is how we will write a combustion reaction for a compound or for a element. Now we'll see what is the formula which is used to find out about enthalpy of formation and enthalpy of combustion in the case of numericals. Okay, so first here I am taking a formula, that is change in enthalpy. Delta indicates change, H indicates enthalpy. Change in enthalpy is indicated by delta H. Now this delta H is equals to HP minus HR, enthalpy of product minus enthalpy of reactant. So this formula is applicable for enthalpy of formation reaction. For formation, a compound, always that a compound is formed on product side. So take first product, then minus of enthalpy of reactants, then that formula will give about the enthalpy of formation. So change in enthalpy of formation is always equals to enthalpy of product minus enthalpy of reactant. This is the formula for enthalpy of formation reaction. Now we'll see the same formula how we can apply for enthalpy of combustion. In the case of enthalpy of combustion, delta H becomes equals to HR minus HP. What is delta H? Enthalpy of combustion or change in enthalpy of combustion. So a compound can undergo combustion and that can be represented on reactant side. So first take that reactant, HR minus HP. HR is nothing but enthalpy of reactant. HP is nothing but enthalpy of product. HR is enthalpy of reactant, HP is enthalpy of product. Okay, now enthalpy of formation and enthalpy of combustion both is given. Now write in the formula. So for example, a reactant XA is involved in the formation of YB. So this is considered, just consider it as formation of B compound. Formation of B compound from A. So if it is formation, then we want to take delta HF. So delta HF for this reaction, what is the formula formation? HP minus HR. Product, change in enthalpy of product minus change in enthalpy of reactant. So coefficiency of this, coefficient of B formation is Y, coefficient of A is X. Okay, so first product we want to write. So enthalpy of product first we want to write. So product is Y moles of change in enthalpy of B minus X moles of reactant we want to write, right? X moles of change in enthalpy of A. Change in enthalpy of A, that is formation of F. So if it is formation, delta FH equals to HP. HP is nothing but enthalpy of product. This is product. How many moles of B product? Y moles of B product. So change in enthalpy of B, we will write. Instead of product, we will write B. Minus change in enthalpy of reactant. Change in enthalpy of reactant is given as X moles of change in HA. Like this we will represent. If it is for the formation, we will represent F here, F here. If it is standard, we will represent not here. So if it is for enthalpy of combustion, Okay, enthalpy of combustion formula, this one. First write down enthalpy of reactants minus enthalpy of products. So delta CH equals to enthalpy of reactants, we have to write x moles of A. X moles of delta H A naught minus enthalpy of product. So y moles of delta H B naught. If it is for combustion, represent here C. That's it. So this is formula which is used for calculating enthalpy of formation and enthalpy of combustion change in enthalpies. Okay, now we'll apply these formulas for calculating problems or numericals in objective way. So here is our first question. So find out change in enthalpy of formation of HBr. Change in enthalpy of formation of HBr in gaseous state. So formation, here they have given options. We want to find out the correct answer. First write down the enthalpy of formation for HBr. So which is forming HBr? Write it on right side. Formation of HBr. So HBr is formed in which state? Gaseous state. To form HBr, the two elements required or constituent elements required are hydrogen and bromine. Write this side, H and Br. We know their standard states. Hydrogen can exist in the form of H2 gas and bromine can be exist in the form of Br2 gas. H2 gas and Br2 gas both are in standard states. Okay, now balance on both the sides. Clear? So only one mole of HBr is formed. Understand? So for that, take one hydrogen, but here we have taken two hydrogen. To balance that, take here half hydrogen. So if you take half, what happens? Two get cancelled, we will get only one hydrogen, and bromine should be in only one. So but here we have taken in two moles, so that take here half. 2 get cancelled, we will get one bromine. That's it. So this is about the final one. So bromine will not exist in gaseous state, it exists in liquid state, just changes. So bromine standard state is in liquid state. This is the final expression for the change in enthalpy of formation of HBr, which is resembled like this. Half H2 gas plus half Br2 liquid gives rise to HBr gas. So our answer is the first one. See, the fourth one is also almost similar, but here bromine is given in liquid gaseous state, but bromine in standard state can exist in liquid state, that you should not confuse. So the answer is the first one. Now we'll see the next question. So C2H2 plus 2H2 gives rise to C2H6. So what is change in enthalpy? Delta H we want to find out. So enthalpy of formation is given for C2H2 and C2H6. Enthalpy of formation for C2H2 and C2H6 is given. For C2H2, enthalpy of formation of C2H2 is given as X1. So enthalpy of formation of C2H6 is given as X2. Okay, so enthalpy of formation of C2H2 is given as X1, enthalpy of formation of C2H6 is given as X2. So keep that in mind and write down enthalpy of formation. Enthalpy of formation delta HF is equals to, so formation, the formula is HP minus HR. HP minus HR. Okay, so first write down change in enthalpy of product. Change in enthalpy for the product, this is product, is given as X2. So you just substitute that value. Minus change in enthalpy for the reactants. These two are the reactants. So in these two reactants, only change in enthalpy of formation of C2H2 is given, but not H2. So first write down C2H2. So C2H2 is given as X1 plus 2H2. For this they didn't give, write it as 2H2. Okay, now the whole formula becomes X2 minus X1 plus 2X2. So in standard state, I already told you their change in enthalpy of formation or combustion should be taken as 0. So consider it as 0. If they don't give, consider it as 0. Then delta HF for this equals to X2 minus X1. So this is the enthalpy of formation of this compound. So enthalpy of formation is given as delta HF equals to X2 minus X1. So this is how the questions will be asked for objective based on enthalpy of formation and enthalpy of combustion. So continuation of this chapter we will see in the next video. Thank you.